Hey guys, my name is Yasmina and welcome back to my channel. I make videos all about books, book recommendations, writing and publishing your book, so if that sounds like something interesting to you, please make sure to subscribe. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I use ProWriting Aid to self-edit my novels. I've used this software for quite a while to edit my novels and I think it is amazing, and so I want to show you how you can use ProWriting Aid to edit your own novels. This will be an on-screen tutorial and we're going to go through a real example of how I edit my own book, but also show you some extra features that you can use that I might not need to use right now, but that maybe you can use. So without further ado, let's get on to the ProWriting Aid tutorial. Okay, so this is the ProWriting Aid website. So this is where you want to go if you want to try the free version. And of course, it's also where you want to go if you just want to purchase the product. But what I do is I go into Start Web Editor. And here we're going to copy a piece of writing that I need to edit anyway. So we're going to do that together. So this is just a chapter of something that I have written. And now you can see that it's starting to look through my document and find any errors. It's gonna take some time to read through the entire document, so let's just wait for that. But in the meantime, you can see up here in the toolbar, there's so many different options and different things that you can do in ProWriting Aid. I can just show you quickly, like settings, of course, you can switch depending on which English you use. I use British English, so actually let's do that. You can of course go into the app yourself and play around with all of these. I'm just gonna show you what I use the most to edit my books with. And of course, like I mentioned before, you can get ProWriting Aid as an add-on for all these different things. So for Google Docs, for Scrivener, and for Word. And of course, you can also have it as a plugin for web browsers to check your emails and things like that. But like I said, I just tend to use the free web version for now. I would definitely like to purchase it for Scrivener or for Word at some point in the future. So ProWriting Aid, if you're watching this, please sponsor my videos. Thank you. Okay, so in total, right now, the program found 16 issues, two of which are grammar issues, six style issues, five spelling issues, and three passive issues found, okay? So we're gonna go through some of them. But first, let's look at some stats, because this is something I really like to see. Before I do any edits, I click on the summary tab. But this is going to analyze the entire chapter or whatever you put into ProWriting Aid and give you some stats. And I don't know about you, but I like me some stats. So after some time, this summary report pops up and I really like this. It gives you a lot of stats. For example, my grammar score is 77, and of course, it needs to be increased to 100%. The style score is 83%. The spelling score is 83%. Also should be 100%. Then it gives you the stats on where the piece looks great, like readability, sentence variety, use of passive voice, bad adverbs, things like that. And then of course it tells you where it needs work. So again, grammar score, sentence length, spelling, conjunction starts, glue index, which I'm not entirely sure what it is, and emotion tells. There is a bunch of stats. I'm not going to go through everything right now because I just want to go back into actually editing the chapter, but I just wanted to show you that you can go through all of these stats. Oh, this is nice. This I haven't seen before. It gives you a word cloud of the most repeated words, which is super nice. Mum, it's something. So that we can reduce. Of course, mum and it's, that's fine. But yeah, you know, there's a lot of really cool stats here. And what's cool about it is that you can take a screenshot of what it looks like now and then compare to after you've edited based on their suggestions. So I'm gonna do that right now. I'm gonna take a screenshot of this particular part because this is where what I care about most. And so back into the document, you can see that now we have 37 issues that it found. It took a little time to find everything else, but I think we should just go right in. Like I said, there's a bunch of stuff here, but what I'm most interested in is the actual editing capability and what it can show us on things that we can improve in this chapter. So let's just jump straight into it. Okay, it says that it's missing a comma here. I'm not entirely sure about that, but for now I will agree. She drops her head onto her hands, into her hands. I
think that should be onto her hands, so I'm just gonna ignore that. Ooh, this I like, see, because it gives a suggestion on using icy claws as a better alternative to cold claws, which I agree, that is much better. And I also miss the space after the ellipses, which of course should be there. Should I heat up the lasagna? I'm gonna keep that because I like it better that way. Ever since I moved out, my diet comprises of. I think consists of is just more used than comprises, and I don't want to change the language to sound weird. I do agree that this needs to be a bit more interesting, but I'm not sure if a novel way is the best version, but I'll keep this for now. Yeah, okay, I think I'm gonna replace the colon or just remove it entirely. Missing comma. Yeah, so we can just remove try and entirely, and just that is slang, so I'm just gonna ignore that. Well, this is a bath water. It's definitely not boiling, because that would be bad news for mum. Can I say scalding water? I'll have to come back to that. The doorbell starts going off versus the doorbell goes off. Yeah, I think that's okay. So now it found a different one because I removed the colon. Now it's saying that it's missing a comma, which I think it is. Okay, so now we're down to zero, as you can see. This was quite quick. I think it found a lot of good ones and had some good suggestions. Of course, I also ignored some just because I couldn't think of a better alternative now, but I can come back to that and change things and improve things later. So let's check out a couple of more things. Let's see what it says under style. Two readability enhancements found. Ah, okay, those, yes, we've already looked at those. And now it's saying that I should remove finally, but I want to keep that one. I do want to keep this adverb because I think it creates a better, or it creates the image that I want. Now see, this one is interesting. You have started three sentences in a row with the same word, and that word is I. So this is definitely something we could improve and switch things up a little bit. So instead of I can do, instead of this sentence, I can do it's the perfect character to represent myself. And then we got rid of one sentence that starts with an I. Of course, we can also do here, but I think this one is fine. I don't have a problem with that one. So this is interesting. So here I'm doing a tell instead of a show, but actually if you read the sentence, I've been so distracted I didn't realize I'd passed the supermarket until I was almost home. We could just remove this. And this sentence on its own should say enough that the character was distracted without me actually having to specify it. So that's nice. So it found more things, which is very nice. Let's see something else. What do we have under grammar? Two grammar issues found. She drops her head onto her hands, but I think this is better. She drops her head on her hands. On her hands? Onto her hands. Okay, let's try on her hands. That might be a good middle ground for this. Okay, and then in overused tab, it's telling me that I've overused the word look. Sounds about right. I do use that word a lot. And here I've used it quite close. Sure, I slide over the book, then search for a distraction. That's better. Okay, and under all repeats, we can see more things here. I fail this. That is intentional. So weekends, I. That is interesting. That's not something I intended. Where is that? Ah, for the last 3 weekends, I. Should I say during the days? Instead of I want to, I'll say I'm switching to a mage. I do have the word lasagna 4 times. Lasagna, lasagna, the lasagna, lasagna. So maybe I can change that. Okay, maybe do, instead of should I heat up the lasagna, I should do should I heat up dinner? I hold the casserole. If it's a casserole, is it a lasagna? Can it be a lasagna? Lasagna is in fact already a casserole. So maybe I can do that instead. I hold the casserole up to my nose. I don't know. I'm gonna leave it like that for now, but I'm not sure. Okay, so under echoes, this is showing me all the close repeats. So for example, us, I have I failed us, and then lend us is magic hat. So instead of saying I failed us, I can say I failed the party. Instead of saying hat again, I can say get our hands on that item. Maybe special item, enchanted item. Enchanted item. Ah, see, this one I never noticed before. First target, this 18-year-old bloke called Dan from Blackpool. No reason, he seems an easy target. So that should not be there twice. He seems an easy kill. Let's go with that. Wanna go again? I'm tired. Let's try tomorrow. I should have brought over more food. I didn't realize it passed a supermarket. Okay. Ever since I moved out, my diet consists of supermarket brand noodles. Ah. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this one again. I should switch one of them up. Grocery store brand noodles. I think that's better. And then we have the microwave. Twice in the same paragraph. Coating the walls of the oven? Microwave is also an oven, technically, right? I think that's okay. I didn't realize it passed the supermarket until I was almost home, so we have home in close succession. Okay, we can do here. During the days I spent with mom. Then under structure, you can see some stats about your sentence structure. I'm not gonna spend too much time on this, although maybe I should. I'm just not gonna do it right now, because that's a lot to take in. So basically, you ideally want to vary your sentence structure from short, longer sentences, really short sentences, and not have two of the same or three of the same all in one go. So that's definitely something I'm trying to work on. So it's good that this tool exists. Okay, so under transition, it's showing me all of the transitional words, so like when and... So I can already see, for example, I rolled a 7 when we needed at least a 9. So I can technically remove this and it should still make sense. And in this one, I can remove and. We've been trying to get our hands on that enchanted item the last 3 weekends. We can remove 4 and the sentence still makes sense. We can remove as we speak here. So this is saying the sticky sentences, and we can try to improve readability a bit here. I should have known. We can remove that. I should have known nothing good could come out of this Friday. We've been trying to get our hands on that enchanted item the last 3 weekends. We've tried getting our hands on. Yeah. Okay, and the last thing I'm going to show you is the cliches tab. We've tried getting our hands on is a possible cliche, but honestly disagree. I think that is fine. And yeah, a redundancy, but I think since this is dialogue, I think people would say it that way instead of, should I heat dinner? Should I heat up dinner? I think I'm gonna just ignore that. Okay, and a last check on the summary we're port, the grammar score went up again, and so did the spelling score. I don't know if you noticed, but all of these other tools were only working for the first 500 words of this document. So because this is a free version, it only works for the first 500 words. So really what I'm gonna do is simply put in 500 words at a time from this chapter and go through all of the tabs again just to find any more things that I can fix and improve. But yes, I think I'm gonna end this tutorial here. I think you got a pretty good idea of what you can do with ProWritingAid, and I definitely think it's worth getting into this and just trying out the free version. Like I said, you can get around these things by just putting in 500 words at a time and it'll still tell you everything. I definitely think it's a great tool, and as a first pass over your first draft, I think it's great and definitely catches things, and it definitely makes you think about how to improve your prose, so I think even that alone is worth it. So yeah, I hope you check this out, and I hope you found this video helpful and you're gonna go edit your own work now with ProWriting Aid.
So there you have it. That was how I use ProWriting Aid to edit my own books. Do let me know, what do you use to self-edit your books? Do you use ProWriting Aid? Do you use Grammarly? Do you use anything else like that? And if you do use ProWriting Aid, do you use it differently than I do? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. But otherwise, if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to subscribe and leave a like. It really does help me out a lot. Otherwise, I will see you next time with a new video. Bye!